Operations means some mathematical operations performed on a random variable in order to know more about the given random variable. Okay, so which means, for example, if I give you the PDF of a random variable, then we cannot understand much about the behavior of the random variable. Okay, so rather, if I do some mathematical operations on the PDF, okay, and if we derive some characteristics based on the given PDF, then there is a chance that we'll be knowing more about the random variable. Okay, there is a chance that we know more about the random variable, which means I've told you one example also in the last class. If there are, if I tell you the arrival times of a bus to a bus stop, then I cannot much understand about the nature of the bus arrivals. Rather, based on the arrival times of the buses to a bus stop, if I calculate the average time difference between two consecutive buses, then what it will tell you? It will tell you on an average how much time you have to wait. Okay, on an average how much time you have to wait to get the next bus. For example, if I go to a bus stop, okay, and if I ask the passenger who is already waiting there about when can you expect the next bus, he might tell you maybe within 8 minutes you will get a bus. On average, we might get a bus in 8 minutes. Okay, so that actually will let you to wait for the next bus or to take another option, to go with the another option. So like that, the characteristics that are derived from the PDF of a random variable will give you some information about the nature of the random variable. Okay, so it will tell you the nature of the random variable. So first order statistics, second order, third order, and so on. Okay, so each order statistic will tell you one particular information that will not be conveyed by or given by any other characteristic. Okay, the first operation is expectation. So expectation, or it is also called as mean or average value of a random variable. Okay, so if there are two things. Okay, first thing is how to calculate expectation for a discrete random variable. So this we have seen elaborately in the last class itself. Yeah, in the last class itself, expectation of x equal to, the notation is, expectation of x equal to sigma I equal to 1 to n xi into small xi into probability of capital X equal to xi. Okay, so for a given discrete random variable, we have seen how to calculate expectation also. So the first row tells you values taken by the random variable, and the second row tells you the probability that the random variable takes a particular value. Okay, so here I've already told you 0.2 means probability that x is taking a value minus 2. And what is 0.15? 0.15 is the probability that the random variable takes a value minus 1, and so on. Okay, so how did I calculate expectation of x there? Sigma I equal to 1 to 6, why 6? 6 is because there are 6 values that the random variable is taking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so the random variable is taking 6 values, and hence I have written 6 here. Xi into P of x equal to xi. It's very simple. So you just multiply the value taken by the random variable with its corresponding probability. So minus 2 into 0.2 plus minus 1 into 0.15 plus 0 into 0.1, and so on. Okay, so all that you have to do is you have to multiply the value taken by the random variable with its corresponding probability, and you have to add all these multiplications, right? So that way you will get the expectation of a discrete random variable. Okay, any doubts in that? So if not, today we will see how to calculate expectation of a continuous random variable. Okay, so I will share whiteboard. So the second case is expectation of a continuous random variable x. Okay, so which is having the PDF as whose PDF is small f x of x. Okay, so there is a random variable capital X and whose PDF is small f x of x. Okay, so now the expectation can be calculated as expectation of x equal to integral minus infinity to infinity x into small f x of x dx. So if you understand the discrete version, the continuous version also tells you more or less the same. Okay, so it is f x of x. So in continuous case, what did we do? I equal to 1 to n xi into probability that x equal to xi, right? So xi here and xi here, right? So it's the same. I mean, all that you have to do is you have to multiply the value taken by the random variable with its corresponding probability. So in discrete case, this is the probability. And in continuous case, if you remember, for a continuous random variable, I have already told you that fx of x, just a sec. For a continuous random variable, fx of x dx is nothing but the probability itself. Probability that the random variable x takes a value in the interval x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2. Okay. So this product fx of x into dx, this itself is nothing but the probability that the random variable takes a value in the interval x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2. Okay, so don't worry even if you don't understand this, but my point is, for discrete random variable, sigma I equal to 1 to n is being obviously replaced by summation, will be replaced with integration in continuous random variables, and xi is x itself. And probability is p of x equal to x in discrete random variable. And for the case of continuous random variables, the probability is nothing but PDF multiplied by infinitely small interval dx. Okay. Am I clear? So that's about how to calculate expectation. Okay. So let me write it again. So expectation of x equal to integral minus infinity to infinity small x into fx of x dx. So here small x equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, and in short form we call we represent expectation as x bar. Okay, so this is expectation calculation, expectation of a continuous random variable. Am I clear? Any doubts so far? Expectation of a continuous random variable. Okay, so shall we see an example of how to calculate expectation of a continuous random variable? So let me do an example. So there is a random variable, a continuous random variable, which is having the PDF as fx of x equal to, let us consider uniform random variable, okay? Uniform distribution, which is 1 by b minus a for x between a and b, okay, and it is 0 for elsewhere. Okay, so what is this, Andy? So this is nothing but the PDF of continuous uniform random variable. Okay, and one more thing I have to tell you is for all the standard random variables that we have seen, what are they? We have seen in continuous case, I mean to say, we have seen famous continuous random variables, right? What we have seen? We have seen uniform, right? We have seen exponential, Gaussian. And Rayleigh. Okay. So for all these famous continuous random variables, it is good if you calculate the mean value. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate mean value of uniform continuous random variable or continuous uniform random variable. Okay. So the problem is calculate expectation of continuous uniform random variable. Guys, are you following? I hope you are following, right? So what we are trying to do now is we are trying to calculate expectation of a uniform continuous random variable. So in the exam you might be directly asked like this. Okay, so maybe they'll directly ask you, hey, calculate the expectation of continuous uniform random variable. Okay, they might not even give you the PDF. Okay, so by looking at continuous uniform random variable, you have to write the PDF and then you have to calculate the expectation. Are you guys following? Amma vintunara? So yeah. Yes. So expectation of x, according to the formula, expectation of x equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity. X equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. Small x into fx of x dx. Right. So now, if you look at the definition of the PDF of continuous uniform random variable, it is